Canabalt doesn't really have very many one-star reviews. A top 10 99-cent game, granted this is generalizing, but for example, a top 10 99-cent game has significantly more one-star reviews than Canabalt did. And a top 10 free game has quite a few. That's the most that he gets, is the one-star reviews. So people that have invested in your game more significantly, they're more likely to feel ownership of that game and give you positive feedback. Also, the support that you might be asked to give to those people, it seems like a different type of person will buy your game at a higher price point than a 99-cent. So you might not have the same support issues. So there seems to be this consensus that generally you have to have your game priced at $1 to make it to the top 10. But we need to price your game more than $1 to sustain the company if you are outside the top 10. We're continuing to we're not in the top 800 games at this point. But we're continuing to make pretty decent money on the Canabalt, which I'm very happy. So, some details about the iPhone port itself. So this is where I have a lot of experience. So Canabalt on the iPhone. So Canabalt was originally built from Flash. The Flash version was built around Flixel. It's a 2D game library for Flash that was created by Adam. The iPhone port, Canabalt, included a quick port of the Flixel library, just bare minimum what was necessary to get Canabalt to run on the iPhone. But very quick and dirty, porting work for Flixel and for Canabalt was completed in just under 2 weeks. It was pretty intense 2 weeks, but still was pretty fast. Also, the port is Objective-C only, no C++. I really like C++, but I really, really like Objective-C. So, it can be very productive. Once you get the hang of it, I've been working on Objective-C for about 5 years now. There's a lot of good things about Objective-C. Some people hate Objective-C properties. There's syntactic sugar. I like them a lot. I think they helped quite a bit keeping the iPhone port of Canabalt very clear and concise. Also, I really like the memory model of retaining and releasing that Objective-C requires. So a little bit about Flixel. Flixel is a, like I said, it's a 2D.